Hi everyone, it's Im here from the blog I Think Therefore I Teach. Welcome to your next criminology video. This is for Unit 2 and it is 4.2. This one is still working with the ideas of policies and how policies have changed. Do not forget this will be part of your summer assessment in your first year. So this is a revision topic. This is a topic you need to revise, memorise and remember. Right. There we go. Okay, so 4.2, explain how social changes affect policy development. Now, I find this topic really interesting, how things have developed and changed over the years to do with policies. This is about how social changes affect policies and laws. So, there's always shifts in society, and so it's how policies and laws have changed because of these shifts. It examines how policies have been affected by cultural changes in norms, values, and attitudes, how public perception of crime has changed and is changing, and the demographic changes, so the population. We'll look at some examples together, then research one independently. So I'm going to just work through what I did with my class and the policies that we looked at that have changed due to social changes. So this is very interesting because it shows the importance of society's voice and how policies and laws do listen to what society needs. Sorry, my computer's going on a go slow today. Values then, what does values actually mean? Values are the general principles, beliefs or guidelines that tell us right and wrong, good and bad. Such, for example, we might value freedom or generosity, individual success or contribution to society. Norms are the specific rules and standards expected by a particular society. So values are things that people value, things that are important. Norms are what is the norm? So don't forget when we looked at deviance in unit one, deviance and the beginning of this unit as well, deviance is where the norms are broken or things that are against the norms. They could be formal, such as don't drink drive. That's a formal legal law, but it's also a norm. You know that you don't drink and drive. Or it can be informal, don't jump the queue, wear your mask when you go inside a shop, obviously for the COVID restrictions. Norms can stem from values such as anti-discrimination laws. This was part of the norms. But these can also come from things like the value of equality. So that's where things like this come from. Mores, these are basic essential norms, so more norms, that society sees as vital. The society's most important moral rules, such as don't take a life, things like incest. So it's the ones that we really hold as most important, the ones that we hold as top as a society. So the first example that we looked at as a class was smoking. There's been a dramatic shift in attitudes towards smoking tobacco since the 1930s. It was used as a social, it used to be a social norm. Doctors recommended it, adverts promoted it. It made it look very glamorous, very sophisticated. It was, you know, in that one, more doctors smoke Camels than any other cigarettes. Doctors, people look up to doctors and associate with it being intelligent. And so if a doctor smoking recommended it, it must be something I want to do. So this, it really glamorized smoking. In the 1950s, it was the first link between smoking and respiratory disease and cancer. This led to a gradual shift in attitudes and doctors no longer allowed to promote it. In 1965, the US Surgeon General confirmed the link with cancer and warnings printed on packets. So it took between the 1950s when they started to think, smoking maybe not so good, might link to breathing problems and cancers, but it took 15 years to confirm that. So it took 15 years for there an actual be a direct link between smoking and cancer. Obviously, you need people to smoke for a certain length of time to see the link, and therefore the warnings were then printed on the packaging. The UK various campaign groups formed, such as Action on Smoking and Health, or ASH. So smoking effect of the campaigns, the effect of the campaigns that came about, various pieces of legislation. 2002, the Tobacco Advertising and Promotion Act banned advertising cigarettes, etc., including at sporting events. So it used to be all right to advertise smoking. I still remember growing up with smoking adverts. You could still advertise smoking. I'm showing my age. You can advertise smoking. These things were then taken out. 2006, the Health Act. It was illegal to smoke at work or a substantiary enclosed public space. So this was things like pubs and stuff. You couldn't smoke indoors, you couldn't smoke on trains. I remember when there used to be a carriage of smoking on the train, and it was always, the toilets were always at the other side. So I remember having to always have to walk through the smoking carriage, and it was like this room of fog. It was always because they had level from the windows and things like that, so you used to walk through to get to the toilet. And I remember when you went to a restaurant, you used to walk up and they used to say smoking or non-smoking, and so you actually had designated smoking areas. All of that was taken away. Sorry, just waiting for my computer to catch up. In 2014, the Children and Families Act, it was illegal to smoke in a vehicle if children are there. You also get a lot of graphic campaigns now, things like don't smoke when you're pregnant, which is the one there, the effects of smoking, the insides of smoking. You have ones with pictures of burnt lungs and comparing smokers' lungs to non-smokers' lungs. I showed my students quite a few. If you do Google smoking campaigns and look at the images, there's a lot of extremely graphic images, graphic campaigns. I always remember one campaign quite vividly that used to be on TV quite a while ago. I think it was an NHS one, and it basically had two persons' fingers walking along with a cigarette coming out, and it basically, the cigarette bud drops off at the end, and it says that it can lead to impotence. Unfortunately, these campaigns are often banned. So whilst they're trying to really do the shock and really stop people just blank of I shouldn't smoke, a lot of these campaigns are banned because people find them really not offensive, but alarming, which I don't know. I don't know your views on that. Do you think campaigns, things like anti-smoking, should be alarming? Do you think that they should be able to show things like that without them being banned? What I then got my class to do was I got them to have a look at women's rights and immigration and race. So they did get a handout to support this, but you can easily do your own research for these areas. How have women's rights changed over history, and things like immigration and race as well? So what was the situation in the past? What changes have occurred, including legislation? And what triggered the change? These three questions are very important. They're three questions that you need to know. So what was it in the past? So for smoking, it was glamorized. What changes occurred? They associate smoking with cancer. What triggered the change? What triggered the change was the associating the smoking with cancer. What changes have occurred, including legislation, that you can no longer advertise, you can't smoke in public buildings, and things like that. So it's, you know, what was it like in the past, what legislation has changed, and what caused that change to happen? So have a go at doing that for women's rights and immigration and race and see what you can come up with. My students also then looked into their own example. They looked into one of the following that interested them. So how drink driving, homosexuality, LGBTQI plus rights, cannabis oil, the death penalty, domestic abuse or divorce. So they looked into one, and again, they did those three things. What was the situation like in the past? So what was the situation like in the past for homosexuality? There's so much online for this one. So that's a really good one to have a look into. What laws have changed? Look at things like the marriage laws and stuff like that. And what triggered these big changes? What triggered the big changes for the LGBTQI community, plus community? What changes, what happened that triggered social change to then start having this effect on policies and laws? When looking at an assessment task then, you would get a question such as, what is meant by social norms? 2 marks. Think about how you'd give a full answer. My students wrote their answer in 2 minutes, and then I gave them the 3 bullet points here. Social norms are specific rules and standards expected by society. They're formal and informal, and they stem from social values. So, for example, value of equality means we have anti-discrimination norms and laws. So that would be a perfect answer. It's only 2 marks, there's 3 points there, but you've got what they are, the formal and informal, and an example. That would be full marks with no bother at all, and you could probably do that fairly quickly. You could do that, you would have 2 minutes to, 1 minute per mark. You could write that in 2 minutes quite easily. We then did an 8 mark question. Using examples, explain how social changes can affect policy development. So that's everything we've just done so far. So examples, so you could do the smoking example, you could do your the one from the list that you looked at, like domestic abuse or divorce. And then you've also got the women's rights and the immigration. So you've got lots of examples potentially under your belt now. All you have to do is explain them, explain how society changed, what it was like in the past, what it's like in the present, and then what policies have developed because of that. So you need a little intro, what are social changes, use an example, explain what happened in the past, what caused it, and the policy. So those 3 points, and then do it again. So straightforward, a little brief conclusion, so easy. Intro, what it's basically asking you, conclusion, and follow the structure of exactly what we've done. What was the past, what is the present, and what triggered it, and what policies changed. Do it for a couple of examples, 8 marks in the bag. Oh, that was short and sweet, wasn't it, folks? So with that, you would have enough to be able to explain that topic. You don't need a lot of examples. There are enough examples there to help you get through any questions you will get in an assessment. So hopefully you found that useful. Give me a thumbs up if you did like that. Nice to keep them short where we can. Also, don't forget to subscribe, so every time I do update new videos, you're informed of this, so you never miss out of any of them. If you have any questions or problems or anything like that, just drop me a comment underneath, and I always do try and get back in touch and reply where I can. Otherwise, thanks very much for now, folks. See you all soon. Bye, everyone.